Hello, Owen McCarthy here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be explaining what I like to call a loose modern pompadour and the steps in achieving this look. In part one of this video, I'll be explaining how I cut the top of this haircut. The first thing I focus on when beginning any haircut is the shape. I visualize the finished look, break the haircut down in my head, and separate it into appropriate sections. I begin with the connection point between the top and sides. Depending on how I want the hair to sit, I will use block or diagonal graduation to create my first guideline for my clipper work. I know I won't be taking the clippers higher than this point. In this case, I've used diagonal graduation, working backwards. The horizontal shape of this haircut is triangular and the vertical shape is square. Through the top, I start with a profile guide directly down the center of the head. This will decide my overall choice of length of the hair on top. I will use a reference point from the crown to gauge my length and work forward in a triangular shape to the front of the head, taking the rounding of the head into consideration. Once I've cut my profile guide, I will then subdivide this section and work in a numeric system, working outwards to the rounding of the head, subdividing and pulling each section into the last. This will ensure I'm creating a square shape, leaving me enough length and weight through the corners to style this look appropriately. So by following this method, I'm going to be left with a disconnection or overhang through the corners. I want to create a technical disconnection, but not through the entire panel. Halfway between my profile guide and my shape guideline, I'll take another section. I'll separate the fringe and split the remainder of the hair into sections, in which I will pull out square and cut out the disconnection, leaving me with more length on the front. What you may notice is that I am cutting the entire shape through the top from the left hand side of my model. This will ensure that I am in full control of my horizontal shape, which I instilled in my initial profile guide. I will repeat the same system on the left hand panel of the head, the only difference being, instead of pulling each section into the last, I will now be pushing each section into the last. I will then apply some sea salt spray before blow drying the hair. This will semi-style the hair before I start my clipper work. Thank you for watching part one of this haircut. Stay tuned for part two, where I'll be explaining how I cut the back and sides.